Well, Buckingham Palace has opened its doors to never-before-seen rooms. Visitors will be able to have a look inside at the palace's east wing after several years of renovations.
It's been the stage for so many historic moments. One of the most famous balconies in the world. And for 175 years, a view that was reserved just for the royal family and their guests. Until now. With the centre room behind it open for us to see for the very first time.
It might seem a bit strange when you're in a palace, but actually this room feels smaller than you'd expect because it's where the royal family get together, they mingle, they have a chat on those big occasions before those doors are then opened and they get to go out and see the public. Now, for the visitors, those doors are going to stay shut, but at least they get to have a peek through the curtains.
While this will no doubt be the showstopper room with the incredible Lotus chandelier, it is just part of an exclusive tour around the East Wing that was added by Queen Victoria. Only now open to the public after 5 years of looking more like this. With 47,000 floorboards removed and relaid, this wallpaper in the yellow drawing room had to be taken down, cleaned and rehung, along with 3,500 priceless pieces. The principal corridor, just one of the spaces where Caroline de Guito helped get them back on display.
It also tells the story of history, the history of collecting, right back to George IV, and many of the contents that are in this wing came from Brighton Pavilion, his pleasure palace down on the south coast. But also it tells us a lot about Queen Victoria and Prince Albert and the way that they had this wing built and the way that they occupied and used it, because many of the pieces that we see here have been here literally since the wing was completed in 1850.
While tours for the East Wing are now sold out, general tickets will still get you into the staterooms, so you can decide for yourself if you like the King's new portrait. A man who is continuing his mother's tradition of opening the palace, and in fact has agreed it can be open for more days. Conscious, it would seem, of the need to justify the public money that's being spent, and to capitalise on the interest that never seems to fade.